The following program is sponsored by Samuel Onuoha Ministries, partners, and viewers.
Hello, precious friend. I am so excited today. I want you to know today that it's not by accident that you are here watching this broadcast. Something good is about to happen to you today. The Word of God is saying, without faith, it is impossible to please God. And this whole series, we're going to be talking about the preciousness of faith. And I also want to honor a great legend that I've gone to be with the Lord, Apostle Frederick Casey Price, a mentor and also a father in the Lord. And I'm so excited that, you know, I've learned so much from him. And some of the things you're going to hear me say today are things I have learned and heard from him. I remember many years ago, I came back from South Korea. And I remember, you know, I remember going to his office. And I just was asking random questions. And one of the questions I really asked him, I asked for a few things on the subject of faith. But I was like, because I was in South Korea, people were reading his books and all that. I said, sir, what is your secret to this? And I remember him saying something to me, said that, get God to be with you. I was asking about the secret to success and all the whole nine yard, you know, and following the things of God in ministry and different things. And he said, get God to be with you. That word hit me so hard. At first, it didn't make sense. But then I understood that is the secret to everything. And sometimes I will go and I say, pray with me. Can you pray? Say, but have you prayed? I say, yes. I say, don't you believe in your prayer? I say, I believe now. Praise God. And he, of course, agreed with me. But I learned a lot from him. And not just what he said, but things I observed him do. Glory be to God, the way he preached and his lifestyle. He really transformed my life. And I just want to, you know, dedicate this whole series to Apostle Frederick Casey Price. And, you know, I want to thank God for him. And, you know, we learn a lot. And I believe that his legacy continues. And as we begin to teach this, I believe there was a deposit several times. I remember the last time he prayed with me, he stood on Deuteronomy, I believe, 34, and prayed. The Bible says when Moses laid his hand on Joshua, the Spirit of God entered him from that moment. I remember him praying for me. Glory be to God. And he laid hand on me. I went to, my wife and I went to his office and he prayed for us. And, you know, we are so grateful. We are so thankful. We learned so much from that legend. I mean, his legacy continues forever. And I want to thank God for the family of, you know, Crenshaw Christian Center and the Price family. Awesome people. Learn a lot from them, you know, and I give God praise for that great family in Jesus' name. So I'm going to be dedicating all this whole series to Apostle Price and the things I learned from him. You know, he taught me what faith is. And I remember him using Hebrews chapter 11. And it says, yeah, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. He used Amplified. The first time I heard this in Amplified, and I'm going to go ahead and read it right now. Amplify Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1. He said, now faith is the assurance, the confirmation of the title, dude, of things we hope for, being the proof of things we do not see, and the conviction of their reality. Faith perceiving as real fact what is not revealed to the senses. He first showed me Hebrews 11 verse 1. With Amplify. And that's when I found out that faith is like a title deed. Glory be to God. Faith is like a title deed. I never knew that thing was in the Bible like that. We've always read it from the traditional King James, but God used him to show me Hebrews 11:1 from the Amplify that the faith is like a title deed, the title deed in your car. You see, that's why the Bible says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. You see, when you don't have a title deed, when you don't have a license evidence to your vehicle, I mean, you're not going to please the police officer that is going to pull you up, you know. So without faith, it is impossible to please God, according to Hebrews chapter 11, verse number 6. So, but today I want to begin to talk about the preciousness of faith. Why is faith so important? Why is it that you cannot do without faith? One of the reasons, number one, of course, we know that, you know, that we live by faith, because that is how we live. According to Romans chapter 1, verse 17b, the just shall live by his faith. That's how we live. And I love the way Apostle Price says this, you know. He said, you cannot skip 1 second from living. You live 24/7 a day, glory be to God. You live 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days in a year, and the whole year you're going to be alive. Yeah. So the day you stop living, the 1 minute the doctor say this guy is not alive, they declare you dead and you stop existing on this planet Earth. So, you know, that is our faith. We live by faith. So if we are to live by faith, that means we are to operate by faith 24/7 hours a day. You cannot take a break from faith. You cannot start with faith and then stop and try something else. In the kingdom of God, the just must live by his faith. We live by faith, glory be to God. That's how we live 24/7. Everything you do in this world, anything that is not by faith is a sin. That is how we operate, glory be to God. And we understand that, of course, grace have also made available, but the faith have to take it, praise God. Sometimes some people may think that, you know, if you are teaching on grace, you are against faith. No, faith and grace work hand in hand. Faith cannot work without faith. Grace cannot work without faith, and faith cannot work without grace. Both of them has to be united, because faith take the receipt of what grace have made available, praise God. So the just shall live by his faith. Without it, you cannot please God. That is the way, that is one of the reasons why faith is so important. It is so precious, the preciousness of faith. Glory be to God.
The preceding program was sponsored by Samuel Onuoha Ministries, partners and viewers.